Yep.
Yeah, AB marker, slate.
So I explained blockchain as a trust platform. In the internet, we connected everyone around the globe. And with blockchain, we can actually ensure that you are speaking to the right person and that you are interacting with the right service, that the person that you are interacting with has the history they say they have, etc. So you can verify history, you can verify credentials, identity, assets, property, ownership. I was working on an healthcare project to record patient-doctor conversations on the blockchain, and I saw the potential of the technology to change the way we are working today in the future and be what we call classically disruption, but it's a positive disruption. It's actually an evolution, I think, more than a disruption. So yes, we are evolving, and new technologies are evolving with us, right? We have new ideas, there's new problems. Receiving a mail is not physical anymore. You receive your email digitally, right? Wherever you are, your location doesn't matter anymore. Being a citizen of the world, right? Difference with legacy systems where you hold the card, you hold the identity, but you don't hold your data. If the system change, you don't transport your data with you. It stays locked into the system you were in. So I'm French, right? All my history of being a French citizen disappeared when I decided to move to the US. I had no financial history, impossible to prove my history because the standards are different, and no one will trust a piece of paper that you are going to bring with you, or even a phone number that you are going to give, for example. And so when I settled here, I was like a newborn, right? No credit score. When the world is itself being global, you have to change the processes and bring new technologies. And blockchain actually solves this, because you connect people around the network, right? A global network, and Cardano is one. And then you can build those processes. You can organize the work stream of people around business processes. We are building a network for the long term. We have an opinionated approach, right, about how you should design a robust platform that is going to support the financial system of tomorrow, right? It's not a small objective. In order to build a network, you need to build it the right way from the get-go, and actually putting some time in designing it, not rushing, right? We aren't here to launch one feature as fast as possible because the market is waiting for it. No, we are going to launch it when it will be ready to be used securely. I would see Cardano as a component of a global trust network, basically. Blockchain being that layer of trust that is lacking in the internet, I think Cardano will be a major component of that layer of trust. You establish trust by being real, I think. At IO, there's no BS, there's no bullshit, right? We have an opinion, we keep repeating the same thing. Charles did that over years and years, and still saying the same thing to everyone. And people can actually judge us on what we deliver and how compliant it is to what was said, right? And there are many evidence of that we are a trustworthy company doing a great contribution. I mean, we are by the biggest producer of open source code. The quality of the code is very good. Governments can actually check what we did and prove to themselves that we are a trustworthy partner for integrating technology. I feel sometimes our industry, the crypto industry, is a bit combative, right? We have to win over X, right? We have to take one more position in the ranking. The ecosystem fear that if some other networks is succeeding faster, that's a problem. That's not a problem. It will help you at the end, because globally we are far from having convinced the world to use blockchain, right? How many countries integrate Bitcoin, for example. We have to convince the world, right? So there's a place for everyone. Contributing is not enough. You need to set a tone. You need to launch alliances. For example, we talk to the others. We actually propose things. Because if you take the initiative of establishing a communication, there will be profitable for both sides. So the next step is definitely interoperability and creating bridges between networks. Because it's the nature of the network, is to grow, it's to connect people, things, and other networks, other people. In order to grow, you have to connect things. When we talk about, working on the main concept of adoption, like where do you go, who do you have to convince, right? It's a difficult task, I think, to pioneer this industry, and we're still in the pioneer age. Like people are thinking that we are arrived, we aren't. If we have to convince the world to use blockchain, we have to do so much work. Like it will take some time to convince governments to use it, to create currencies, but also to express international standards and the regulation to catch up also, the law to catch up. Why? Because the law is here to organize business processes to protect people. And you need to be protected in a global economy. We have a lot of work in terms of working on specific verticals, identifying those verticals and where they are. And working with the users that, or the adopters that who actually need it the most. Working with the developing world is for Cardano is an amazing opportunity because there's many things to improve, many systems to put in place. And we have the chance to actually design those systems and our mechanism with those emerging economies the right way at the start, and not trying to bridge an existing legacy system that is here for decades and bridge it to it's a different work, right? So it's an amazing opportunity, and I think blockchain in the next few months or years will develop rapidly in emerging economies. There's a mix of rigor, creativity, because we are a very creative company where we have hundreds of ideas per month, and you have to select the ideas with the most potential, and you have the ambition of delivering something. And that's very interesting to be part of this and trying to achieve that goal. The objective of Cardano for 2025 is to reach 1 billion users. So users can be people or devices, but that's the goal. It's an ambitious goal. The bar is really high, right? And the fact that people keep pushing with the vision and delivering what is expected is amazing. It's a process, right? It's not easy.